Hello, I am Professor Vishala Patnam. This episode is on Love Begets Love. These are the kids belong to my Wisdom Children's Welfare Club. We all have love for animals. This is the story of Ash and Oreo and Ash family. Oreo is male and Ash is female cat. Ash fell in love with Tiger and begot three kittens. Two remained with her and one was taken away by someone for upbringing. You can see this is Ash family. We named the kittens as Simba and Cooper. Cooper looks like maternal uncle. And Simba looks like father. Unfortunately, on 27th January, Cooper died in a road accident while crossing the road with his family. It was brought to my notice by Ash and the colony kids. The names for the kittens were given by my daughter, Kiran. This is Simba. Tomorrow is National Science Day, 28th Feb. I thought of posting this episode as it is going to be analyzed in a scientific way. For me, science is nothing but systematic observations and experimentation of the physical and natural world around us, collecting the results and validating them, making the systematic structure of all those facts to make the body of knowledge. This episode is named as Love Begets Love. As I'll be talking, I'll be showing the pictures of the cats and their routine. I vividly remember it was first week of March. Due to lockdown, people remained indoors. That is why, in particular, the cats had tough time to pilfer food from the families. It was morning 6:30. I was having coffee by sitting on a chair in my front yard and enjoying the nature. The climate was lovely on that day. All of a sudden, this Oreo comes inside my house, sits near my feet with a loving tone. By saying meow, meow, it started communicating to me that I am hungry. Will you please give me something? The way it looked at me and the way with a loving tone it tried to communicate to me, I felt happy and also a bit guilt because I was having coffee and it was hungry. So immediately I got up, went inside the kitchen and brought a bowl full of milk and offered it to the brown cat, which was named later. This is Oreo. After drinking milk, Oreo went in outside the house and brought one more cat. This is gray color one. This is later named as Ash. Both again demanded in the same loving tone for milk. I thought might be they both are related. And as Oreo studied me that I was kind to it, it brought its sister too. So again, I had to give one more bowl of milk to Ash. Both had. And next day, sharp at 6 a.m. only, they came and sat in my veranda. When I opened the door to open the gate, that is my routine. I go out and open the gate for the milkman and come inside and do my routine work. These two, as a milkman used to come, they used to wait for the milkman. The milkman used to come between 6:20 to 7 a.m. They used to wait. Once I take the milk, they used to demand for milk. So I started taking extra milk to feed them in the morning and sometimes even in the evening. After having milk, both used to play in the garden, in the compound, and on the walls. We have a long compound wall. They used to walk on that and enjoy. Sometimes they used to defecate and urinate in the compound. It used to stink. So I made it a practice that they should quit the house after playing. They should not remain inside the house for a longer period. Later they realized that and they also got habituated to come in the morning, drink the milk, play for some time, move away, urinate, defecate outside, and they used to come and enjoy. Sometimes they used to sleep in the veranda and enjoy as per their convenience. After some time, Ash became pregnant and it gave birth to 3 kittens. This is the first day Ash came with the kittens and lovingly trying to introduce them to me. I was surprised to see Ash was introducing me when I was coming out, stepping out, in their language, and the kittens were looking at me. So beautiful it was, so touching. I started taking extra milk to feed the kittens too, because they became very important members of our family. Early morning, as I opened the door, they used to follow me and demand for milk. That is why I used to take extra milk and keep in the fridge. And little morning I used to vomit little and I used to bring the milk vessel with a cell phone and just the way they used to surround me and demand for milk and run towards their feeding area is very interesting. So I tried to catch 2-3 times to enjoy the moments. Whenever I wanted, you could see that. I never planned before that I would be making an episode. Please remember that. It became a best pastime in this COVID times. They used to love me. They used to care for me. They never used to come under my feet. They used to walk around me, but never under my feet. They never bit me. They were very understanding. I used to keep the milk for them, extra milk, in the fridge. Morning I used to vomit and used to offer, because they never used to leave me. The moment I used to open the door, they used to just demand for milk. Well, it used to be always between 6 to 6:30. That is the time I used to get up. If at all I get up before 6 and also open the door, I had to offer them. They used to wait for the milk. Early morning only they used to come and wait for me in my veranda. They were so prompt. They had so much time conscious. Sharp by 6 a.m. they used to be at my door. I was amazed to see their sense of timings. Irrespective of the climatic changes, they used to be there at my door, main door, by 6 a.m. Both Oreo and Ash, after the kittens were born, they also 4 used to come and slowly Oreo started sacrificing its milk for the kittens. Oreo slowly stopped coming and started hunting the rats. In the neighborhood, there are many rats in others' families. So they used to at least catch one or two rats and used to have nice dinner, lunch, nicely. Sometimes Oreo used to bring other friends too. Then that day I had to give up my curd share of milk for the cats. Sometimes you can see in this video clip also, one day five cats came and Oreo, the way lovingly it communicates to me that, please offer milk to all of us. So nicely they drank here, so they're licking up their paws. Okay, what I learned in this process when I was scaring them nearly from March to this Feb, the ash became mother. I saw ash as a teenager, I saw in mother's role during pregnancy, and the way they take care of their younger ones, marvelous. We need so many people to attend to the newborn baby. But Ash used to take care. Tiger and Oreo also used to help sometimes by getting some meat. They used to kill the rats and used to bring it. Sometimes I used to see, they used to cross by. Behind my house, there is one empty house. They have not occupied, it is empty. The house is empty, so they used to enjoy their backyard for having their non-veg program. The best thing what I learned from them is they're very time conscious. They study their environment. They know do's and don'ts with the master. Like shitting, defecating, urinating, I don't like. Within a week they understood that. That makes me upset, the master. And they used to go away for urinating and defecating. Later they never did it. For 1 week I used to chase them. After they play for some time, I used to chase them out. So the takeaway point from them is they get conditioned easily and they are very sensitive to the master. Whoever cares them and loves them, they also understand what we don't like and what we like from them. It was very surprising for me because this is the first time I was dealing with cats and animals. In my village also I never had an opportunity because I used to be busy with studies and helping my father in the factory. Later in the hostels we never had any pets. Then after I came to Parbhani, I became very busy professional all the time, worried about my responsibilities as a professor and later as a mother. Never had time to look around and care for the animals and bring them up. They had time sense, whether it rained or never rained. See, sometimes you know the time, you will not understand whether it is 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. because of the climatic changes. But these cats were very sensitive to the time. By sharp 6 a.m. because this is the main door I used to open and they used to be there and they used to wait for me to come out and give. So whenever it used to rain, I used to bring the balls to the veranda. So that also they knew that now I go out, they used to wait there. They never used to wet their bodies. So they were very good managers of themselves and their surroundings. Except for some time playing with them and giving them milk, there was no maintenance issue for me because they used to care themselves. See, here you can see a few cats. As pictures come, you'll be saying that, okay, they are not arranged in sequence in a haphazard way. As I used to take the pictures, some few videos I have added. This is the five, all the cats came one day. Like that, three times they came in this whole season, that is from March till today. Only three times they brought their friends too. During lockdown period, the club children, few of them bought nice dogs and they used to bring them to play in my compound. That is the time they used to, these cats used to climb on the tree and very, very scared of the dogs first 2 days. Later they were not scared. They gave up that. They also felt that one. These are also others' pet dogs also are part of my house. So they used to just move away from the site. But they were not that scared of dogs later. Three dogs used to come. Those were the pets of the club kids. So they used to come with them and play here. See, you can see them again here. So, and I had few videos about they walking towards the dining area for having milk in the mornings. One day the milkman did not come as it was raining heavily. Oreo, Ash and its kittens came and they were waiting. They tried to communicate to me that when are you giving milk? When I did not answer to them and I was just waiting inside, they understood that something is wrong. They patiently waited. When the vendor was there at 7:30 a.m. It was late, but still they were quietly. First they started saying meow meow and waited. Afterwards, when I did not respond, so beautifully they understood that something is wrong. The milk may not be there. I do not know how did they thought of, guessed it, but they did not demand it. Just quietly they were sitting near my scooter. I only felt bad for them, like how to communicate to them that I don't have milk. I gave them bread. They ate little and they did not like that much. They wanted only milk. So around 7:30, few vendors came for selling milk. Then I bought two packets and one packet milk I gave to them. They were so happy. The way they looked at me, that I cannot forget. The affectionately they looked at me that you made up. The milkman has not come. So I felt they cannot communicate in words, but if you see their body language, their expressions, their toning, when they say meow meow, that toning also indicates that yes, they are also considerate to us. I realized that their body is very flexible. They can get inside the small grill space too, to go out, to move out. Sometimes you may see how they used to go out. Through the main door also they used to go out. Sometimes through the grill from the washing area they used to go out. Only this is a clip once I think my daughter had taken. Without telling me, from the terrace, she used to sleep upstairs. From there, she took this picture. They have flexible body as well as flexible mind. They are very accommodative. We had to learn from them that how did they cope up? We were so upset as people during COVID season, you know, situation. But the animals in general, the plants, even these cats, I saw that how beautifully they got used to the difficult circumstances. It was amazing. Whenever I used to meet them in the morning, my day used to start with optimism. They don't grumble at the lacuna. They try to face the challenges by thinking smartly about the alternate solutions. It was so amazing for me to see Ash training its kittens. Very particularly, it used to train the Cooper and Simba what to do and what not to do. What not to do, if they repeat, it is to go and with the pass, it is to punish them too. And after some time, it used to cuddle them and feed them very lovingly. Three of them used to sleep together. Sometimes I used to see Oreo sacrificing its milk for the kittens, its nephews. They have warm relations. They are very understanding. They think of only today and be happy. They don't think of too much about tomorrow. That is a big lesson I learned from them. They have tremendous memory. What is where and how to go in and how to from where to come in. They were very familiar about their surroundings and the material. Sometimes they nicely used to enjoy the clothes we used to put for washing purpose. Then they used to climb on that. The old clothes and the bed sheets used to be like a cushion when they were dumped in one place, and they used to go and enjoy on the heap of the blankets and bed sheets. Then I used to enjoy them. As I used to go out, they used to run away from there. This is the first time I was giving the kitten. Now it was first time it was tasting milk. Without mother, it came inside and it had Simba. These birds used to come and the cats used to watch them and enjoy the sight of birds coming to my house. Ash was very upset when Cooper died. For 3 days, whenever it used to see me at home, it used to cry and tell me, trying to communicate to me that I'm very upset. I lost my son. It was very touching. So, not only humans, animals also want to tell their masters about their grievances and sorrows. They love to share it, though I did not understand much. The monkeys also used to come whenever the other monkeys and dogs, whenever they used to come, they used to hide near the cart and the scooter and used to watch them. Whenever I used to give them bread, the monkeys used to enjoy the bread and peanuts. I think nature is a big teacher, especially the kittens and cats. When I was caring them for some time, children must learn from them to have independent behavior, to have good habits, to follow the parental instructions, to be disciplined, to be time conscious, to be resourceful, to face any kind of challenges, not asking for too much help. Here you can see Cooper and Simba having milk with mommy. The right side is Cooper, to my left is Simba, sent this Ash mother, so loving. Always they used to run away. And they used to have, you know, I used to keep little bit away the katoris. They used to have milk fast, and each one used to drink with a different speed, and it was difficult for me to catch them together. So this is the story. Sometimes I used to keep their pictures in my WhatsApp status and even on social media, Facebook. Not only the club children, my family members, but others too also started
Good
loving.
Good morning. Today's the rising sun, which
that
I have taken from my terrace.
I thought this
These
episode
are evening
should have the title of Love Begets Love. It bonded
when I was listening
us,
to the, news article,
the cats with unknown people, me with
from
unknown
the
people.
Next colony.
And
they
bonded
were by
our club
house.
Children and me
when they were
with
passing
the cats.
By, they felt where they're sitting and observing.
And these
people.
Are the monkeys sometimes used to
Five
come.
Families, three
I just
on
kept
the trees.
So that every animal teaches us
insight.
Lots
I'm
of lessons.
To catch them.
Not only the plants.
See, now they,
you have to take time to enjoy and learn
the
from them.
Few peanuts and
having lots of
pieces,
resources also. We are very bad managers. Of
this
our
is
life
one more family.
And bad manager of our environment.
Three are on the branches inside the trees.
I wish children see this
kept cell phone
and
in the
start
window.
Learning not only just from books
to capture me alone
and TV programs
in the veranda window,
but also by caring and having little bit compassion.
Few monkeys were playing on
for
the
animals and plants around them, and
this
learn
a
lot of
the
good things.
Is sitting and relaxing and observing other families.
You just see here how adventurous they are.
One is going off.
Mother has given them enough freedom. Not only children, even it is a.
The younger ones are following the mother's.
Big opportunity for all of us.
They seem to be very good friends.
Whenever we are bored,
every monkey
instead of saying
its
the word boredom,
like our group,
let everyone observe the nature.
Six.
Whatever to the extent you can.
One monkey has.
Care for them. Care for it.
Look at this younger ones.
So that you also derive
trying to climb
lots of love from them. This here you can see Simba is trying to watch the children playing on the street.
Vaishnavi, Simba.
Sitting inside, it can't see. So you can see that Simba is there in between the branches.
Simba.
And looking out.
Simba.
And enjoying the children whom it knows. It is familiar with all club children. It's enjoying the children enjoying the play on the roadside. See here, it is very clear. Simba. So, love begets love. So, let us love the things around us and care for it as much as possible. Thank you. From Simba. Bye to all. Love you all.
Simba. Hi.
Simba.
Simba.
I realized the animals are the best researchers, best resource managers, have better understanding about themselves and about others. First time Simba saw the umbrella, but it knew how to utilize it. Cool breeze was coming, it had rained. This is a Jimmy. Jimmy and Daisy. Daisy also comes sometimes, so I kept those two pictures because they were also associated with the cats. They never tried to harm the cats when they were around them. Only thing is, they used to move away. The cats used to run away from them. Here Simba is telling, because Ash is away from the umbrella and enjoying Simba being under the umbrella. So Simba is telling, listen to the parents, protect yourself like me, love Simba.